Welcome to another video on solving trigonometric equations. The goal of this video is to solve trig equations that involve inverse trigonometric functions. On this first problem, we want to solve this equation for x on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, including 0 and not including 2 pi. Well, our first step is going to be to isolate the sine functions. Let's go ahead and subtract 1 on both sides. That would give us 2 equals 20 sine x minus 3. Now we'll divide by 20. That'll give us 0.1 equals sine of x minus 3. Now what we can do is take the inverse sine of both sides. Now on the right side, inverse sine of sine x minus 3 will just equal x minus 3. Remember, these are inverses of one another, and they will undo each other. And we have the inverse sine of 0.1. We'll add 3 to both sides. Now let's go to our calculator to evaluate inverse sine of 0.1. And this returns an angle of approximately 0.1002 radians. So x will be approximately 0.1002 plus 3, which gives us an x value of approximately 3.1002. Now we have to be careful because we're not done. Inverse sine 0.1 returned an angle of 0.1002 radians. And this angle would be in the first quadrant. But remember, we're trying to solve this equation on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. Remember that the sine function is positive in both the first and the second quadrant. So a reference angle of 0.1002 radians in the second quadrant would return the same sine function value. So another angle that would produce the same function value would be pi minus 0.1002. And this would be 3.0414. So even though this angle is not in the range or the output of this inverse trig function, that's okay because this inverse trig function is not part of the original equation. So there'll be a second possible value for x. Instead of using this angle, we can use 3.0414 plus 3 is approximately equal to x. And so we'll have x is approximately also equal to 6.0414. So we have two possible solutions for x for this equation on this given interval. Let's go ahead and evaluate the right side on the graphing calculator and see if we do get 3. So the first possible value for x was 3.1002. And that's close to 3. Remember, this was a rounded value, so that looks good. And then for the other value of x, we'll type in 6.0414. And again, very close to the value of 3, so it looks good. Let's go ahead and try another problem. 4 arctan x equals pi. Let's go ahead and isolate the arctan x by dividing by 4. Arctan x equals pi over 4. Now if we take the tangent of both sides, we can isolate the x. And if we take the tangent of the arctan x, we'll be left with x. Remember, this returns an angle that has a tangent function value of x. Then we want the tangent of that angle, so it would just give us x. Tangent of pi over 4, which is 45 degrees, will give us 1 over square root 2, which rationalizes to square root 2 over 2. So that one's pretty straightforward. Okay, here's another. Now remember, inverse sine 3/7 represents some angle theta that has a sine ratio of 3/7. Let's go ahead and model that angle over here in this right triangle. This is our theta. The opposite side would be 3, and the hypotenuse would be 7. Now let's go ahead and rewrite this using theta instead of inverse sine 3/7. We would have inverse cosine x equals theta. What we could do now is take the cosine of both sides. And remember, if we take the cosine of inverse cosine x, we will just have x left. So we have x equals cosine theta. Well, over here we've modeled angle theta, so if we can find the cosine of this angle, we can find the value of x. Using the Pythagorean theorem, we know that 7 squared must equal 3 squared plus, we'll call it y squared. So we'd have 49 equals 9 plus y squared. Subtracting 9 on both sides, we'd have y squared equals 40. Taking the square root of both sides, we have y equals the square root of 40. Well, 40 is 4 times 10, so this would be 2 square root 10. We don't have to worry about plus or minus 2 square root 10 because we knew from the beginning, since the inverse sine was positive, we were going to be in the first quadrant. So since we can now find cosine theta, which would be the adjacent side, or 2 square root 10, over the hypotenuse, which is 7, we've found the value of x. So some of the equations involving inverse trig functions can be a little tricky, especially this last one. I hope you found this video helpful.